Looks beautiful, doesn't it? I'm so excited about my new bookshelf. So it was empty all this time, which is why the last couple of videos, I shot with books around me on the floor, and I was hoping to put them up in shelves this Sunday, sit and sort and actually shelve them well. But then I have some friends coming over, and I had to just stuff them in, so that's what I did. And so there's no order, it's just chaos out there, but it's just so beautiful, isn't it? I just can't stop staring at it. So I'm so excited today about getting my bookshelf up again after so many years that I decided to do this video with three books that I'm going to randomly pick up from the bookshelf. So it's kind of like maybe a book bingo. So I'm going to randomly pick up numbers, then go find the book on the shelf and talk about it. Right, so whatever, either I've read it or I've not read it, what I liked, whatever, right? So I'm going to share three books with you from my chaotic bookshelf. Okay, so now let's go with book one, right? So let's see, shelf number 3 and book number 16. All right, so let me get that book. The first book that I have is Utakaman. Now, this is written by Frederick Price. I hope you can see the book. Now, this book is quite an old book. I bought it more than 10 years ago. And I remember falling in love with it. So I bought it initially just because it would be so cool to have this book on the shelf. But when I started reading it, and I absolutely enjoyed this book. Now, why did I enjoy this book? So I have grown up in this little hill station called Ooty or Utakaman. So the hill station in south of India is called Utakaman, but people lovingly call it Ooty. And I've spent many summers of my childhood in Ooty, and there are a lot of memories I have of the place. So reading a history of this place that I grew up in was just so amazing, because I knew what they were talking about. I've seen a lot of these places, and it's a beautifully well detailed book. It's very academic, that's true. It's not really like a story, but if you're okay with that, then this is a great book. And if you're someone who has history with Ooty, you definitely enjoy this book, right? So, highly recommended, Utakaman, the History by Frederick Price. So, now to book 2. What if we pick up shelf 5 and book 13? So, let me go find the book. The next book that I have is Time to Kill by John Grisham. I'm hoping you can see that book, right? This was the first book I read of John Grisham. So again, this is quite a favorite. It's the first book I read of John Grisham's, and it made quite an impact. I absolutely fell in love with courtroom drama. He writes amazing courtroom drama. This is his first book that I read, and this is a story of 10-year-old girl who gets raped and killed by two drunk boys, and the whole state of Mississippi. So this happens in Canton, Mississippi, and the whole place goes up into chaos and riots and all of that. And then these two boys, of course, have to go to trial. So how does this work? Because in those times where this book is set, right, black people were not really treated well, or were not even considered, their life was not worth much. So that those are the kind of things that he talks about. He kind of, it was my first book that I read that really talked about racial violence, and it made quite an impact. It was quite an eye-opener. So this is a book that is one of my favorites. And I'm glad it came out randomly, right? Which is like really cool. So yeah, that's Time to Kill by John Grisham. And now it's time for third book. So let's see. How about book? I have only 6 shelves. So let's say we pick up shelf number 2 and book number, let's see, adventures 20. I lost my number 3. So the third book that I have is also quite amazing. I don't know, considering the chaos that my shelf is in, I'm not really sure if all those books out there are books I absolutely love, or is it just that I'm lucky today, right? But all the books that I picked up randomly, really, really randomly, have been perfect choices. So the next book that I have is The World of Malgudi, and this is written by R.K. Narayan. Now, R.K. Narayan was one of my, was kind of the introduction at some level to Indian writing, and he writes so amazingly well. So I first came across R.K. Narayan when I watched the TV series called Malgudi Days. It was made into a TV series, and I fell in love with that and picked up the books to read. And I mean, they're not the same, of course. They've deviated from the book in making the series, but it is still so cool. And books are just amazing. R.K. Narayan's writing is so light and airy. Very, very enjoyable. It's a light read. It's not taxing at all. It's feel good. And his narration is, you know, very, very, it's almost like someone's, you know, your grandmother is telling you this story. It's like a, it's a really good storyteller telling a tale. So I love the tales of Malgudi, and there are just so many in there that are my favorites. There's the Sweet Vendor. There's, of course, Swami and Friends. Yeah, so The World of Malgudi is my third book for today by R.K. Narayan. This is a collection, of course. So it's like, you know, there are a lot of short stories and books that R.K. Narayan wrote based on this fictional town, Malgudi, where he set a lot of various characters and all of that in the whole process. So, and each character has a story. So all of those are kind of collected. This is just one part of it. There's much more than this to all that he wrote. And yes, so that's The World of Malgudi for you. Alright, so that's book 3, which is Malgudi Days. I mean, this is the book World of Malgudi, but the whole collection of Malgudi and R.K. Narayan's work is my choice for number 3. These are the 3 books that I have for today to share from my chaotic bookshelf. I hope that I get time. I don't think I'm going to have the time to sit down and sort the whole thing out at any time, but you'll get to watch it evolve in the background as we go along, and I sort it out and set it out a little bit, right? So that's it for me today. You can subscribe to my channel below. It's the best way to keep track of updates as they come out and videos that I post, so you'll get updates when I post a video. So subscribe below. You can also follow me on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and Goodreads. You find all the links in the description below. I'll also put in links to the books in the description below if you'd like to check them out. So that's about it. Bye bye.